Okay, so I hope you guys saw the video. Okay, so we got only Dibyanshu here. Okay, so let us start by introducing ourselves. Okay, Dibyanshu, please introduce yourself.
Hello, so I'm Dibyanshu and I'm studying in Valor Institute of Technology and currently I'm staying in Kolkata.
Preeti, can you please introduce yourself?
Hello everyone, I am Preeti Agarwal from my IIT college, living in Kolkata and now pursuing PMS Media Science and now working with LWT as an operation manager. Thank you.
Okay, so myself, Aditya Mukherjee, I am from Kolkata and right now I am pursuing a course on BBA in Entrepreneurship from IIT College and after graduation, I want to start my own business. Thank you. Okay, so you guys saw the video. So, tell me, what's so unique about the name Doodhwala? I mean, why the name was chosen for Doodhwala only? Because you see, in general, Doodhwala, the name Doodhwala does not sound so interesting. So, why do you think Doodhwala was applicable for this startup, the name Doodhwala? Dibyanshu, what do you think?
Sorry, I missed the introductions actually. So, Doodhwala is a milk delivery startup, right?
Yeah.
So, like, can you just give me a brief, like, what it does and how is the business model? Just a summary, actually.
It's a milk delivery startup, and along with that, it also sells groceries, just like Big Bazaar, Grofers, etc.
And is it in metro cities or just like is it just recently started?
It is a failed startup actually. It started in I guess 2012, and in 2019 it failed. Okay. It shut down in 2019. It's a failed startup.
No, it started on 2015 for 4 years.
Yeah, 2015, right. And it is shut down right now. So what's so special about the name Doodhwala? Because Doodhwala sound very dull name actually. So why did they still apply the name Doodhwala? What do you think, Dibyanshu?
Actually, I don't think it's a dull name. Like, according to me, it's like simple. I can just guess its purpose from its name only, actually. Like, what's the main purpose of this startup? So I don't think that it's doesn't need to be like very interesting, like Amul or something like that. It's okay to be Doodhwala. It's fine by me, actually.
So Preeti, what do you think?
I think the logo, like, if you are choosing your brand name, it should be short and simple. And that's all the Doodhwala did. It keep that name short and simple. Easy to pronounce.
So, now you see, one of the reasons why Doodhwala failed was that it was too much dependable on its investor. So, why do you think there are several startups who are always dependable on their investor for money? So why do you think is the reason for that? Why do startups become so dependable on investor that if they don't give any fund, then they would surely fail? So what's your opinion about that, Dibyanshu?
Yeah, I saw its business model right now. So according to it, it didn't charge any delivery fees when it sold milk, right? And it's also sold the milk at MRP. So they were not getting any profit or not getting any actual profit made by them. And then according slowly and like continuously, although they raised money around 100 crores, they got still dependent on them for their extra profit or extra revenue for feeding their own employees. So that's one of the reasons, like their pricing model and their business model was not up to mark and it was not great.
Preeti, what's your take about that?
Same. I totally agree with Dibyanshu. Depending on investor is not always a solution, but yeah, they depended on the investor because they need money.
Okay.
To feed their employees and all. Because they for the profit, they don't have so much of profit or annually, or they don't getting any profit so much, and they are selling their products on MRP only. Like growers and all, they have funding from the starting, but they have very low funding according to growers or big basket and all. So that's why.
Okay. So, for example, let's assume that you are starting a startup. So, how do you hire the right people for your startup? Because you saw one of the reason why this startup failed because they hired the wrong people. So, how do you know that which person is right for which particular job? Divyanshu, can you tell us how would you hire the right people for the right job?
If I were to hire some person for some job, then I would first like to make a what experience does he have with him with working in the relevant field. Does he have any experience or is he starting right now? And if he does have experience, how much quality of work did he put in, and how much output did he generate? So I would like to measure him according to that. But even if he's new, then if he has some capabilities, like if he has some knowledge about that, and I would like to give him a try, like for 1 month, for a period of a short-term period, to see whether he can generate some output. So like that, if I were to hire some person.
Okay, so let's say you hire a person who is very skillful and capable, but he is not so motivated, or he is not so dedicated to contribute towards your startup. Then would you still hire him? Preeti, what's your take on that?
If he or she is not interested in our company to work with the dedication or motivation, why will we hire them? Like, we can't force someone to work, right? So it's about their interest. If they want to work, they can apply. And if they don't, then no issue with that.
I think it's our responsibility to generate some interest in them, right? So if we do not put any reward or incentive for them for the work they put in, how will they be motivated actually? So if we put in satisfying amount of incentives or rewards, and then also they're not motivated, then that's a different problem. They're not fit for the role only. So we would first have to see the environment also, like what they are, what their factor, driving factors are for motivation, something like that.
Okay. So, Hari sir, I guess you are a bit late. So, today's topic was about Dudhwala. So, before we discuss about it, Hari sir, can you please introduce yourself?
Yeah, my name is Hari Kutty and I am from Mumbai, currently working with NCI. And I am a BE in instrumentation. Post that, completed my PGDM from Wellinkers in marketing and HR. So currently I'm involved in a startup which is into laboratory and analytical instruments. Yes. So I got a personal call today. So sorry, because of that, I was not able to join. Yeah. So I missed the, I missed the case study part of Dudhwala. So if you could brief me what was the, if anyone in the group, it would be great.
Yeah, I am briefing. It was very simple. It was about Dudhwala. Dudhwala is actually a failed startup. It started in 2015 and it shut down in 2019. And there are several reasons because of its failure, like, for example, over hiring of people or assigning wrong people for the wrong job, and also over dependability on the investor and many other factors. So that is why it failed. So we were
From where is the startup, Dudhwala? From where they started? Which place?
That I don't remember actually.
Okay. Fine.
Okay, so Hari sir, my question was, if you are hiring a person for your startup, so how do you hire that person? For example, if a person is very skillful but he is not so motivated to work towards your startup, or not so ambitious, so would you still hire him?
Yeah, actually, hiring itself is you need to check whether the person or the candidate is in aligning with your goals, with the organization goals or your goals as such. Okay. And I don't think you will find the ideal candidate every time. You hire 10 people, out of that only 5 may be ideal or 8 will be ideal. It depends on the skills that you acquire gradually and with experience. So no one can analyze. There is no machine or anything that can tell whether the person is honest or whether he is going to work for you in future or not. Okay. And being motivated is a different thing. Okay. No person in a job or a private company will always stay motivated, because if candidate be motivated? Because he is getting only a fixed income, fixed salary, and his target or maybe his job role will be like you have to do entire everything, you have to take the company along with you, everything, this, that. So no person will practically be as such. I think he will be too much of motivated with what all things are discussed in a job role. Okay, so only thing is, some people are very they are keen or curious to learn. So such people will always stay motivated, and you need to analyze what the candidate is, how his experience is, how is his job role, everything you have to check while recruiting. So I hope I made some points clear.
Yeah, sure. Okay, so Hari sir, can you please tell us, there are several startups who become very dependable on their investor for money. They become so dependable that if the investor refused to pay funding, then the startup would surely fail, just like Dudhwala did. So, what is the probable reason for that?
No, I will always say the investor money is like a loan. Okay, you need to return it back with interest or with profit, or you have to show something on paper so that the investor will be at least have some faith in you and some confidence that his money is in safe organization or a safe company or a safe person. But if you are always like thinking, I am going in loss, my company is going in loss, some investor will come and invest on me, on my company again. So it is difficult for that company to survive. So I think dependency on the investor money, if you have this this thinking that this money is a loan, it's not a free money, it's a loan, you consider this as a loan, you have to repay it back along with interest. So if you are going with that motive and with that aim, no investor will ever say no to you for investing. Okay, if your startup is valued and you are working very hard and you are working very, very well, then definitely one or the other investor will approach, and he will get some ideas. He will feel like your idea is worth investing. Then definitely you will get an investor. So what about your take on that? Or anyone else?
So according to me, I think that many startups become dependable on investors because they can't generate enough revenue, and they can't generate enough revenue because their product or service is not good enough. Mm-hmm. If your product or service or your marketing is good enough, then you can generate revenue yourself only without depending on anyone else. A startup start depending upon investor only when it's more money focus instead of customer satisfaction focus, I guess. is more interested to make more profit instead of providing customer satisfaction.
Correct. So same thing happened with WeWork also, I guess. They got a lot of investment from SoftBank, and eventually they just had to sell their entire company to SoftBank itself.
Okay, sure. So now, at the start of the video, you those who saw the video, you might have saw that Jack Ma said that a wise person learn from other people's mistake. So why do you think it is necessary that we learn from other people's mistake instead of making the mistake ourselves and then learn? Why do you think it's important? Preeti, can you tell us?
So in my point of view, every day we learn something new. So it's about learning. It's not about if we do mistakes or some other people do mistakes. If we also do mistakes, we also learn up from our mistakes also. It's not only about their mistakes. We learn from our mistakes too.
Question was, it is being said that it is more important to learn from other people's mistake than committing the mistake ourselves. So why do you think it is important to learn from other people's mistake first so that we can avoid it in future?
I would like to add something.
Yeah, sure.
So the simple answer is life is very short to make all the mistake yourself. And you cannot make all the mistakes yourself. Rather, you can learn from mistakes what others did, and just it is from experience only that you will learn and you grow. Okay, because even in if we see history, why do we learn history? What is the purpose of history? There is nothing as such. If you are a science graduate, or if you are going to, your aim is to become a doctor or an engineer, then why history is necessary for that? So history is just because you get to learn from the mistakes that happened in the past, just so that you will avoid those mistakes, or when such situations arises in future, you know very well how to tackle it. You use your own analytical skills just to avoid that mistake. So I think that is the main reason. I believe that is the main reason that you should learn from others' mistake and keep learning about startup failures, so that we understand how it is important to know why a startup has failed. Because when you have your own vision, or you start your own company or a startup, so you some situation might come arise, similar kind of situation. So if you really remember, or if you really gone through all such things, maybe somehow you will find a way out of it. That's what I think.
Okay, sure. Dibyanshu, what's your opinion about it?
So Hari sir told almost all the things only, but according to me, for example, I used to do I still do the case competition. So from there, if I want to win something, I need to know like what other students have done mistakes in their case that they did not win, and what are the success stories as well. So I need to avoid as much mistakes I need to make there, and focus on making more of the right points. So it generally takes that this, if we want to make more success, more go for success points. So we need to learn about others' mistakes, get feedback from them, like what was the experience, how did you avoid it, or how did you go through it, and how did you like alleviate the experience of pain that you went through it. So that's from me. Yeah. So that is the point that is important according to me.
Okay. So just as Harish has said, studying history along with science is very important, because history teaches us which famous people made which mistake, so that we can learn from it. But still, a lot of students hate history. doesn't want to learn history or doesn't want to study history. So what do you think is the reason for that? Why do people hate history to study history? Dibyanshu, what's your opinion?
First of all, the education system has made it like a rote learning system, right? It did not make it more interesting, actually. So if we do not know the purpose of why we are studying history, nobody would be interested in knowing what the content is if you don't know, like if they do not have any motivating factor, actually, like it would help them in the future or it would help them avoid something. So that's the main reason, I think.
Oh, sure. Hari sir, what's your opinion about it? Why the student doesn't want to learn history?
Rightly said by Divyanshu. I would like to add some more points to that. Education system has already been changed and efforts are being taken by our ministry to change the education system. So hope the new system won't have the same drawbacks or loopholes. And another thing is, it's a personality trait. Like some people don't like history because they feel history is very boring and there is nothing to learn from the mistakes. Or learn from the, if Akbar did some mistake in long back, how it's going to help me today. So it's a purely a personality trait, and it's purely how you take the things. Okay, if you can't really correlate with the situations, then it is actually it is making no use to the person who is learning history. So that is the reason behind that most of the people don't like history. Some won't like mathematics because these integrations, derivatives, they don't understand and they are not able to correlate. So some people will be like that. So it is totally a personality trait as such. And it depends from person to person, his likes and dislikes.
So, Hari sir, one more question for you. You see that topic history, we can know history from by searching Google only. If we are required to find out about a particular event that happened in the past, then we can just Google it and find it out ourselves and know it ourselves. But still, in school, we are required to rote learn it. We are required to memorize it, which is very difficult for everyone to memorize. So do you think history should be removed from the syllabus, from the school syllabus, the entire history portion? Because you see, history can be learned from Google also. We can learn history from Google. So what's your opinion about it?
Yeah, learning from Google, I don't call it as a learning because you can find anything in Google. You can learn science also in Google. You can learn MBBS, medicines, but you won't be educated or you won't get that education because learning is a different thing. You can read and you can experiment, but getting educated or getting a degree is what you makes you expert in that. So you can learn many things when you learn through a book or through your own syllabus. But if you Google it, you can find anything. N number of things, everything is there in Google now. So Google has been advanced a lot. When we used to study history, at that time, internet was not there. So even we felt like it's very boring, and but still we have to study, and we did study, and I think it cannot be removed. It shouldn't be removed from the syllabus. It is required. It is a part of our curriculum. It is required, and it definitely teaches the students with all the previous mistakes and experiences. If we study the World War, how it happened, why it happened. So many things are there to learn. So overambitiousness of Germany, then Adolf Hitler. So many things, many personalities you will come to know. And it's very interesting to know all such people. Okay, so there are many a few of my friends who like Hitler, like their role model is Adolf Hitler. So even I liked Adolf Hitler very much when I used to study history. So that is the thing. So you will always find some personality which you can correlate, or you will find something very interesting or a role model in your life. So even Mahatma Gandhi is also a very good leader, like from non-violence it's a unique technique, like using non-violence to protest. So no one in this world ever will try such type of things. So, but he tried long back. So that is the thing. You will learn such people in history. So it should be there. It shouldn't be, but history keeps changing. That is another thing. So with generation, it will change. So maybe we can expect a few more people to be added and few pages missing out from the new history syllabus. That's what my take on that.
Yeah, sure. Dibyanshu, what's your opinion about this?
Yeah, so according to me, history should be there because if we talk about learning it, Google is always there, but it does not provide the perspectives of other people actually. Like there was a teacher in my class who used to make history more interesting by making it a case study actually. Like if someone did something in the past, so she used to pick up two people. One used to give arguments about why it is right and another used to give about why it is not right. So from that, we used to grow our perspectives as well as some alternative solutions, or we can learn from them. So this type of practical case studies or like solving it through group study, it would be more fun actually, and more learning could be acquired. So I think it should, if it is done through this way, it is more viable to learn history. But there are some other teachers who just do those classes for the exam purpose, right? So the marks purpose. So if that is the way, the students would not be interested at all. It makes it completely boring. So it depends on the perspective of teacher as well as the practical learning experience which we get through history.
Okay, sure. Now Dibyanshu, one last question for you. Since you saw the entire video, so what do you learn from this video, Dibyanshu?
Yeah, first of all, the over-dependency on the investors was a great negative point for Doodwala. And second thing is that their pricing strategy, they should have been reiterated upon those strategies, like how they could get more profit or how they could generate more revenues through it. Along with the GTM strategy, the market strategy was also not good, I think. Like they were just focusing on some of the major cities like Hyderabad or something like that. But if we see that the milk cities like the Gujarat or where it is already located, I think if they could have partnered with those companies, it would have gathered more customers as well as some part of revenue as well, if it could have generated if they go through some ideation. Yeah, so that's it, I think.
Okay, so same question. Okay, so I guess we are running out of time. So that's it for today. Goodbye, everyone, and have a good night.
Yeah. Aretra, could you post the link on WhatsApp of that case study, Doodwala case study? I'll just...
Yeah, sure. In the LWP group, right?
Yes.
Okay, sure. Okay, thank you everyone for joining and good night.
Good night.
Yeah. Bye.